All right. What causes muscle cramps on a ketogenic diet, and how can I fix them?
Well, often muscle cramps are a sign of decreased magnesium. Can be decreased potassium too, but oftentimes the driver of that is low magnesium levels. Now, I will tell you, you hear talking about cramps on a ketogenic diet, but honestly, cramps are one of the most common conditions anyone comes into a primary care physician's office for. So they are universal, whether you're on a ketogenic diet or not. And they can be frustrating to people of all kinds. I mean, they can impact young athletes and they can impact people who are much older. So it is not a problem confined to anyone on a ketogenic diet. But if you are on one or not and having an issue with muscle cramps, magnesium is definitely the number one thing that you want to do. So supplement. Our magnesium levels in our population are low, period. Again, this is not confined just to a ketogenic diet. Unfortunately, our soil has less magnesium in it these days, and so we're not getting as much naturally as we used to hundreds of years ago. So magnesium is a reasonable choice for many people to supplement with. And as I was talking about before with the diarrhea question, there's a couple of different ways that you can supplement with magnesium. There are the short-acting magnesium supplements, such as magnesium oxide, and there are the longer-acting magnesium supplements, such as SlowMag. And again, short-acting can sometimes cause diarrhea or loose bowels, so it would be ideal for someone who maybe has struggled with constipation in the past. But if you're not having any issues with your bowels and want to keep it that way, SlowMag is a good option as well. Now, besides magnesium, another potential problem is that you're not getting enough sodium. So again, especially early on when you're beginning a ketogenic lifestyle, it is fantastic to be making sure that you are getting enough sodium. How do you do that? I mean, we recommend increasing the salt in your food. We recommend bouillon a couple of times a day. Or if bouillon isn't something that you enjoy, or especially if it's the summer and really hot, pickles can also be used to just ensure that you're getting the sodium intake that you need.
And it might be helpful to mention too that most of our magnesium is stored within our cells, so when you do a blood test of magnesium, it may not appear that you are deficient in magnesium, but yet it still is.
Right.
One of the most common causes.
That's a really good point. And so a lot of times, even physicians will judge magnesium need based on a blood test. But the blood test does not look at magnesium intracellularly. So there's no good way to measure that. And magnesium is very difficult to truly overdose on. I always give people the example of when women go into preterm labor and they come into the hospital and they're trying to stop preterm labor, which of course is cramping, right, of the uterus, what do we give them? We give them mega, mega doses of magnesium IV. And so, you know, magnesium, you can't gauge very well through a blood test. So if you're having cramps, take some and see if it improves your symptoms.
Cramps or twitches or Charlie horses or...
Yeah. The whole nine yards, right? Because they can be problematic and always tend to occur worse at night.